back into the match?
Well, that's the doubles final, and of course that is to come later this afternoon. But as you can see down on the centre court at the present time, players have taken up their respective ends, Steve Denton and Johan Kriek, for the Marlborough Australian Open Men's Championship singles final. And for further introduction to the players, we take you back once more to our courtside microphone and to Peter Landy.
Player at the northern end court has arguably one of the fastest serves in tennis, and with that he was successful in taking out five Grand Prix doubles titles in 1980, three of them with Kevin Curran, including the tournaments at Indianapolis, Denver and Bale, a combination which also reached the Wimbledon quarters, and they were runners-up at Washington and North Conway. Last year, 1981, they combined again to take out the Stockholm Open doubles, the United States clay court doubles. They were runners-up at Queens and semi-finalists in the Grand Prix Masters. In singles, he's made great inroads up the ATP computer. In March, a little more than 12 months ago, was ranked in the 400s, and with good results, including a quarter-final berth at the Players International in Montreal, a semi-finalist in the New South Wales Open, and other good results, as well as in this tournament defeating Eddie Edwards, Kevin Curran, John Alexander, in the quarterfinal Shlomo Glickstein, and in the semi-final yesterday, Hank Pfister, who is now one of the top-ranked players in the world. He's from Texas. Would you welcome Steve Denton? His opponent won his first Grand Prix title at Sarasota back in 1979. And since then has strung together a number of good tournament performances, including in 1980 being runner-up in the Grand Prix tournament at Stowe, was a semi-finalist in San Francisco, Los Angeles and the Australian Indoor, as well as being a semi-finalist in the United States Open, and in that match led Bjorn Borg two sets to love. In 1981, he was successful in winning Monterey, the Hall of Fame tournaments at Newport, Rhode Island on grass, was runner-up in the WCT finals at Dallas, a semi-finalist at Bristol, a quarter-finalist at Wimbledon, a quarter-finalist again at Stowe, and successful in winning the doubles, and here in Australia, a semi-finalist in the New South Wales Open doubles. His tournament victories in the Open have been over Drew Gitlin, Thomas Hogstead, Chris Lewis, Tim Mayott, and yesterday in the semi-final over Mark Edmondson. Ranked 19 in the world, he's the tournament's number 4 seed, originally from South Africa and now living out of Naples in Florida, Johan Kriek. Our umpire for the singles final in the Marlborough Australian Open is Mr. Franklin Chaplin.
Two minutes, gentlemen. One minute, gentlemen.
In the concluding stages of the warm-up, and we'll soon have play underway. And it promises to be a match of contrasts, a fitting climax to this Marlborough Australian
Open. Ladies and gentlemen, Marlborough Australian Open men's singles final between Steve Denton of United States of America and Johan Kriek of South Africa. The best of 5 12-point tie-break sets. Denton won the toss and elected to serve. Linesman ready. Ball boys ready. Time, balls to Mr. Denton, please.
Well, Steve Denton's going to be the server in this opening game, and I think this is right here. We'll get a good guide of whether he's very relaxed or whether he's a little nervous about certainly what is the most important final that Steve's ever been in. And it might set the pattern for his chances in this match. He starts off serving aces, then it's going to be a pretty tough day, I think, for Johan Kriek.
I would say that, and I'd have to probably check right back through the records, he's not been in a Grand Prix singles final before.
I'd say that's right, yes.
Players ready.
So for his first Grand Prix final, it happens to be a Grand Slam event, which is
serve.
Remarkable performance this week from Steve Denton.
That's the call to play from umpire Franklin Chaplin, set to go. Denton serves first in the Marlborough Australian Open final. Creek draws first blood.
Love 15.
And again, it's the backhand passing shot, particularly the one down the line that he used to such great effect against Mark Edmondson in the semi-final.
Love 30.
Well, Denton a little tentative with that volley and missed with the first serve on the opening 2 points. So an early chance for Kriek. He really would love to break this serve first game and try and get right on top.
That's more the style.
15-30.
Oh, that's good.
30-40.
And a break point right at the outset.
Game, Kriek. Kriek leads one game to love, first set. Be seated, thank you. Kriek to serve.
Well, that's the scene from our camera position. The Clark Mobile Crane situated behind the northern stand here at Kooyong. And down on centre court, Johan Kriek serving for the first time in this match. Having a service break in hand already against Steve Denton in the opening game.
Love.
And he really did play a fine opening game. Three outright winners. Of couldn't really blame Denton's poor serving or anything in that game, just superior returning from Kriek. That's how he started against Mark Edmondson yesterday.
Love.
Yep, that smash left Denton standing. Serve
40
was good.
Love. Game Kriek. Kriek leads 2 games to love.
So the early advantage in this match going with Johan
Kriek. Please.
Some late arrivals just scurrying to their seats as Denton prepares to serve for the second time.
Double fault. Love 15.
Taking Denton just a little while to find the range on serve. And of course, Kriek really pressing the advantage on that, hurrying, scurrying, and hitting the fine passing shots.
Love 30.
Well, Steve Denton's just a little bit tense down there. It's understandable. Haven't really been in a major final like this. Wind is swirling around and he's understandably a little nervous.
Fault. Double fault.
Three
in a row, so...
Love, 40.
Really bad luck for Steve Denton that he could get off to a start like this. He served okay in the first game. It was great returns from Kriek that caused the initial break. But this time... Love, 40.
Game Kriek. Kriek leads 3 games to love. Time. Be seated, please. Quiet, please. $15. 15 love.
Three games to love and 15 love with Kriek in command.
Love.
He really has great balance, Johan Kriek. Tremendous speed, but then he balances himself so well. Those last two volleys are an example of that.
Double fault. 30-15.
Occasionally his feet go from underneath him on the dry grass, but I bet he can't believe it. 2 days in a row or a start like this.
Game, Kriek. Kriek leads 4-0. Quiet, please.
So this first set is just about gone for Denton, but he needs to hold a serve here just to help him feel like he's getting into the match.
Help. 15, love. Double fault. 15 all.
Makes 4. You probably heard Denton telling himself to get the ball up a little higher.
First service.
Keith Billingham, the net court judge.
Forty-15.
Well, 3 out of 4 first serves in this game, and that's the result, 40-15.
Fault.
2 double faults in this game.
40-30.
Well, I think what he's got to do is just take a little pace off the first serve. Let's try and get his rhythm and his timing going. Let the confidence build it up a little bit by getting some in, and then when he's done that, he can start to increase the speed again.
First service.
Although by the look of that one, I don't think that's the plan that Steve has in mind. I think he's just going to keep blasting. Johan Kriek certainly has got some fine shots. He's already hit a lot of passing shots, and that time perfectly disguised lob.
Advantage, Kriek.
And that was a much slower first serve.
Love.
That's another break.
Game Kriek. Kriek leads 5-0. First set. Time. Quiet, please.
Steve Denton's first serve percentage running at only 40% through the three service games he's had in this first
quiet,
set.
Quiet, please.
And a bunch of double faults in there as well, five of them. Kriek serving now for the first set, leading 5-5.
Fault. Fifteen-love.
Well, as we indicated at the start of this match, Steve Denton served the key and not working as yet. That's why he's down 5-5.
Out. 15-all.
I noticed him at the change over there just try out the restrings of a couple of other rackets. Perhaps he's thinking of getting on with a different tension.
Thirty-15.
Certainly got to try something. This first set is history.
All.
See it again. Kriek got caught on the hop himself here. Point for Denton.
30-40. Fault.
Help.
And that is a break back.
Game Denton. Kriek leads 5-1.
Well, that'd certainly be some encouragement for Steve Denton, but I thought bad tactics in that game from Kriek. Stayed at the baseline. When you're leading someone 5-5, you don't stay back and rally with them and give them a chance to get their feel. You keep the pressure on, keep boring in on them.
That's good. Just landed right in the corner.
15-love.
Mm-hmm.
15 all.
Well, that was a good example of the strength of Johan Kriek. That ball was short, low. He still was able to, strong enough in the wrist to hit that passing shot down the line. He had to stretch forward for it.
Help. 30-15.
Denton serving a lot better in this game. Still haven't quite got the range there.
Thirty. Quiet, please. Game Denton. Kriek leads 5-2. Time. Be seated, please.
Denton still in the first set, but it's Kriek serving for it again at 5-2.
Correction. Lay it, please.
That was it, and it was right on the line.
And the reason Kriek was annoyed was that he had a very easy shot to put away to win the first point. Now it has to be replayed. And he's lost the first point.
Love 15.
Denton springing up and down. He feels that perhaps he's not out of this first set yet.
Service ace. And the first one of the match.
15 all.
Surprisingly to Kriek and not to Denton.
Double fault, 30 all. 40-30.
And Kriek not putting this overhead away. Denton missing the forehand. So that brings up set point for Johan Kriek. That'll leave a mark on the ball boy's leg.
Well,
this hit like that just rocketing into his leg.
Quiet, please.
He'll be stung.
First set, Kriek, 6-2.
Well, those last couple of games were important for Steve Denton. He really didn't have a lot of chance of winning the set, but at least he got a couple of games, and that's lifted his confidence. And he's now at least into the match. And if you lose that set 6-6, that opening one, you're actually not in it. He's in it now, serving first game of the second set.
Love. 30-30. Fault. 30-15.
Well, Steve Denton just telling himself to throw the ball up. He really does have a quick swing, and if that ball not quite as high as he wants, he'll serve a few doubles.
New balls, please. Game Denton. Denton leads 1-0, second set.
It's a ball girl bringing out another racket for Steve Denton, so whether he's just had that repaired, obviously he has, otherwise he would have had it out with him. He didn't take it back out onto the court, so we'll keep a watch to see if he changes to that at the next changeover when he notices that it's there.
Quiet, please.
Kriek serving, won the first set 6-2. Very impressive opening to him. Dan Love won in the second set.
Fault.
Phew, only just missed.
15-15.
There's Denton there just testing the tension of his racket. May change to that racket that the ball girl just brought out during the break.
out. 30 love.
Denton just holding up his hand in apology to Keith Billingham for almost taking his nose off as that ball went past.
Love. First service. Game, Kriek. One game all.
And we've got Kriek with the set in hand. 6-2. Not too many people get those. Ah, too good.
Love 15.
Amazing. Put it up. Kriek was ready
Quiet,
for it.
Please.
And a smash there, just too effective. And again, boy, remarkable speed and stroke making from Kriek.
Love 30.
Denton's got his two first serves in this game and yet finds himself down. Love 30.
Kriek slipping there, but still with that good racket work.
Oh.
Love 40.
Talking about earlier about his balance, he's still able to maintain that good racket work and control even when slipping.
Game, Kriek. He leads 2-1. Time. Be seated, please.
Kriek with the break, 2-1 in the second set. Just has the touch.
15 love.
Just too much all-round ability at the moment for Steve Denton.
Denton just shakes his head.
Out. 15 all.
Just watch the speed here of Kriek.
Unbelievable.
He got that easily, actually.
Yeah. I think it was trying to avoid the net that caused him to just to push the shot wide.
Well, that's one of the few unforced errors that he's made up to this point in the match.
Number two.
15-40.
And so for the first time in the match, Ryan, Steve Denton has a break point.
Got it.
Game Denton, two games all.
I should have said for the first time in this set. Breaking, of course, in the sixth game of the first set when he was down 5-love, but he's levelling now, two all, second set.
In terms of first serves in, he's actually serving the better of the two, but of course Kriek's all-round play and he's better returns.
Double fault. Love 15.
Seven double faults in the match for Steve Denton. His first serve percentage in the first set ran out around 47-48%. He's lifted that to about 65% to date. And that's his first service ace for the match. It's been a long time coming.
15 all.
You consider we've been seeing him serve anywhere from 15 to 20 in his matches so far. Kriek is merciless, isn't he, on the second serve. His own first serve percentage only running at about 30%, but it's his general all-round play and those sort of returns that have been keeping him in the forefront.
Out. 30 all.
Great.
30-40.
Yes, he does well to hit a passing shot off here, the ball keeping low, just rolling it across court, what an angle. So a break point immediately after dropping his serve.
Advantage Denton.
Every time a player has had break points, they have achieved the break.
Double fault. Juice. First service. Advantage Denton. deuce. Advantage, Denton. Game, Denton. Denton leads 3-2. Time. Be seated, please.
Well, Steve Denton now leading 3-2, so he's back into the second set.
And that's the first time he's had break pointed against
Quiet,
him, and
please.
He's managed to forestall the South African. Kriek to serve. 2-3, second set.
This big crowd here would really like to see him get into the match.
Double fault. Love 15.
It was a lucky break for Denton. Said you go to church this morning.
Quiet, please.
Well, a let-off in this game for Kriek. He's not serving that well, having to rely on his second serve, and Steve Denton's making too many errors on the second serve. And Johan Kriek getting in two first serves and losing the point. Steve Denton likes the pace. He likes the first serve coming in.
Out. Advantage, Kriek.
That's a great pickup.
Not up. Game, Kriek. three games all. Love 15.
Well, that's been the match-winning shot over the last couple of days in this tournament for Johan Kriek. A backhand return of serve down the line.
Fault.
Pretty formidable facing that first serve, wouldn't it? Coming down at you like that.
Fifteen all. 30-15.
Yes, I think Denton would be a lot happier if both he and Kriek were getting all their first serves in. He for his own sake, and for the reason that you mentioned before, he does play better off Kriek's first serve than he does off the second.
15. Game Denton. Denton leads 4-3. Time. Quiet, please. Fifteen love.
Kriek is the one that's playing a catch-up tennis in the second set. So far, there's been one break each way in this set. After Kriek, of course, had powered through the first 6-2, having led 5-love.
30-love.
That's one of the reasons that Steve Denton misses so many second serves. He doesn't move his feet, stands very upright. It's across the line and hit through the ball.
Forty love. 40-15. Game, Kriek. Four games all.
Well, outsmarted himself.
Love 15.
I don't think I'd be playing drop shots against Kriek. Got that on the top of the bounce, actually.
Yeah, he was really there for it from the moment that Denton hit it.
All. Oh. 30-15.
Well, Kriek feeling he's missing some opportunities here. Denton missing with the first serve in this game.
He hasn't put one in four.
I think he can consider himself lucky to be at 30 all, actually. Desperately needs a couple of big ones.
Four.
40-30.
It really was a let off for Denton there. I mean, he was Kriek had him dead to rights.
Yes, he just didn't stay with the ball. He just pulled away as he was hitting it. I think he was thinking of recovering for the next shot in case Denton picked it up.
Nice.
Game, Denton. Denton leads 5-4.
Well, he missed five in a row before getting one in. Pretty lucky, really, to get out of that game.
Yes, his first serve percentage for that game was almost 0%. instead of 16 point whatever it is, it works out at 1-6. I said before, his first serve percentage, in fact, is higher than Kriek's. They're both having trouble on serve.
Well, Denton's probably averaging a double fault a game, which Kriek isn't.
Yes, he's served 8.
He would have served
time.
8-9, 17, 9 times. So Steve Denton serving 9 times in this match and serving 8 doubles. Averaging just
quiet,
about
please.
1 a game.
Difference between winning and losing, isn't it?
4-5.
Love. 30 love.
Denton just slowing things down a bit. Johan Kriek plays the points pretty quickly. Doesn't take a lot of time. Really likes to keep the pressure on. Gee, that is a beautiful right. Volley.
Backhand half volley from
40 love.
Backhand volley, rather, from Kriek, just as Denton said, too. Good boy.
Help. 40-15. Double fault. 40-30. Registered as a fault here. It registered as a fault here.
The ball landed inside the line.
It really, I thought it landed inside the line also.
We watch it again. Now
that definitely landed inside the line. So
it only registers when it's played.
Oh, thank you.
Well, that's an example of just another slight discrepancy in the surveillance equipment.
Double fault. Deuce.
So two doubles there, and Johan Kriek, I think, losing concentration. He was very quickly to 40 love. And now has to work to hold the service game. Of course, he's only 2 points from losing the second set.
Out. Advantage, Kriek. Game Kriek, 5 games all.
So Kriek back on the rails and hold serve. Much tighter second set now that Steve Denton has got into the match.
I can't on those close ones. The register is there. If I see it clearly, I'll overrule. Yeah. Right. I will. Yeah.
Franklin Chaplin just assuring Johan Kriek that he will overrule if he sees the ball good.
I think what Kriek was asking him, will he overrule the machine? That's what he was asking him. I don't think we got a clear answer to that.
Help. 15 love. First service. 30 love.
Didn't take much off that second serve,
no,
did he?
No, that was about as good as most people's first serve, that one.
That's good.
30-15.
Wide.
Fault. The ball was wide.
Yeah, it was.
Out. 30 all.
So again, Denton with missing with four straight first serves. Can't keep it up and expect to keep holding his serve.
Didn't miss by too much. Denton giving it the huff and puff
40,
again.
30.
Good, and that's game.
Game, Denton. Denton leads 6-5. Time. Quiet, please.
Johan Kriek had a lengthy discussion on that changeover with umpire Franklin Chaplin. And now Denton drawing.
Something's reflecting in the crowd,
the
I
gentleman
think.
With the blue tie having a watch on it shining in the player's eye. We just... Thanks very much. Thanks very much.
Steve's saying, you can take your watch off, I'll tell you the time. And
quiet, please.
Denton,
quiet, please.
Kriek had a lengthy conversation with Franklin Chaplin during that last changeover, again, about the electronic service line equipment. Suggesting, I think, that they might as well turn it off.
Love 15.
Yes, he said that it hasn't worked all week, so why bother now for the semi-finals and the finals? But I think it's important that they use it if it is working with someone with the speed of service of Steve Denton.
Out. 15 all. Oh.
Bad luck for Denton there. A golden opportunity. He'd have had Kriek dead to rights if that had found its mark, that down the line shot.
First service.
Out.
out 30-15.
Denton missing with three return of serves. Really is a bit erratic with that return.
Game Kriek, six games all. The tie break will now be played.
Steve Denton to serve the first point.
Second service. Denton.
Oh, it's better work from Denton. Just push that ball back down the line. Took his time. Didn't try and rip it off as he normally does with a huge amount of pace and end up sending it rocketing out of court.
Denton really had his chance in that point.
One all. Two-one, Kriek.
Well, if Steve Denton could just pick up a bit on his ground strokes, he'd get back into this match because Kriek hasn't been serving all that well. Denton's had a lot of opportunities on the ground strokes, but just making too many unforced errors with that shot.
Great return. Really caught Denton.
3-1, Kriek.
And that puts Kriek ahead in the tiebreak, taking a point against Denton's serve.
That's another.
Once
Kriek gets the serve back, and it just relies on all-round tennis skill and control, that's where he is in control. 4-1.
Kriek.
Well, very quick tiebreak. And very quickly, Kriek 5-1 up. Players change. And Kriek with one more serve now from this northern stand end.
Six, one. Kriek.
Five set points now in the second set.
That is the second set. Two sets to love now, Johan Kriek.
game. And second set, Kriek, 7-6. One set all.
Two sets to love.
Correction, two sets to love. Time.
Well, Johan Kriek really in the box seat now. 6-2, 7-6. Second set tightening up a bit, but Kriek always looking to have an edge. He's not serving all that well himself, but once the ball is returned by either player, Kriek certainly...
seated, please.
Better all court game. Not making the same number of ground stroke errors.
Be seated, please.
So Kriek serving first game, third set.
Quiet, please. Love 15.
First two sets have taken an hour and 12 minutes. All told.
15 all.
Denton's first serve percentage through the second set was about the same as the first, 47.66%, and Kriek's is only 50% himself.
Well, as we've said, the difference is if Johan Kriek serves a few faults, Steve Denton can't take advantage of the second serve. He's making errors off that.
Juice. Advantage, Denton.
Big chance for Denton to get ahead in the early stages of the third set. He needs a break somewhere.
I wish he'd just chip some of those returns sometimes. Doesn't seem to do that at all. He really relies on going for that backhand, a full drive every time on the second serve, and he's making too many errors off it.
Advantage, Kriek. New balls, please. Game, Kriek. Kriek leads. One game to love. Third set. Very well. time.
So Johan Kriek leading two sets to love and one game to love in the third set.
Quiet, please.
And Denton to serve with new balls. Kriek says, see, it ain't working because that was in. Actually, I thought it was a fault, but
yeah.
No doubt about that.
Double
one.
Double fault. Love 15.
Takes his tally to number 9.
Gee, that is a good return.
Love 30.
Yeah, I think that was the hardest hit serve for the Denton sent down all day. Caught the chalk too.
Out. 15-30.
Steve Denton, he's really in trouble now.
Juice.
So Denton gets back to juice behind his second service. And he'll have to continue to rely on that. First serve just not working.
Advantage, Denton. Game, Denton, one game all.
Well, Steve Denton slowing that first serve down and going for placement rather than power. It worked. It's held serve.
Wow. So the first one is hit.
Love 15.
Well, he's
pretty close.
Pretty close to it as we watch it again. He's been going for an awful lot. Finally, he's probably made one other.
Out. 15 all.
Johan Kriek certainly hasn't had to play too many volleys.
Fault. Double fault. 15-30. First service.
Denton slaps himself down the thigh and says, at last,
15-40.
Yes, he's finally strung two together in the one game. Well, that's a lucky break for Johan Kriek. Dead net cord there when you're down break point. Denton still bouncing around. Knows that this might be his last chance. Well, he's got a second serve.
Double fault. Game Denton. Denton leads 2-1. Time. Quiet, please.
Well, it's amazing, really. Both the players are having tremendous difficulty with their serve.
Well, they've been break points in every game so far in this third set, Gary.
Please.
And one service break.
Second service ace from Steve Denton.
15-love.
Takes ace number 5 for the match. He'd like to have served about 3 times that number, I'd reckon.
Swinging wide past the forehand.
Love. Out. 30-15.
Yes, right on it.
Game Denton. Denton leads 3-1.
And I think the crowd right behind Steve Denton as we watch from our courtside camera, that service ace straight down the centre.
Number 6.
He's leading 3-1 now in this third set.
I'd love to see him get a set, wouldn't I?
Well, I think if he can get a set, he could go all the way then. Creek's not serving that well.
15-love.
I'm sure he'd like to go off, actually, and have a chat with his coach, Warren Jakes.
Thank you.
Well, Kriek didn't move to that at all.
15 all.
He thought it was going out.
Yeah. Doesn't pay to think sometimes.
Second service. Help. 30-15. All.
Hmm.
30-40.
Chance for another break for Denton. Only just.
Cheers.
Well, Steve Denton's pretty loose out there. Looks like he's enjoying the match.
Advantage, Kriek. Game, Kriek. Denton leads 3-2. Time.
So still Denton leading 3-2 in the third set.
Tell you what, he went within a whisker of 4-2, didn't he?
4-1, yes. 4-1, rather. Johan Kriek's game just showing signs of faltering.
First service.
To give the play on words, his serve has been faltering right throughout. That's what's helped keep Denton in things up to this point.
Help. 15 love.
And again, he really put the power down on that second serve.
Fifteen all. 15-30.
Oh.
15-40.
That's too good, isn't it? And the break back for Johan Kriek.
Game, Kriek, three games all.
Well, that shot was a good example of picking just the right type of shot for the occasion. He just chips this, just slides it down the line. He knows he's got Denton out of position, so it doesn't go for anything fancy. He's broke back, three all.
Love.
That's number two for Johan Kriek.
Love. Out. 40-15. Game, Kriek. Kriek leads 4-3, third set. Time.
Kriek leading 4-3 in the third set with Steve Denton to serve. Very big crowd here at Keong today. Came in late, but just about a full house.
Love 15.
Kriek running off three straight games after being down 3-1.
Love 30.
The lapse early in the set, but back on the rails again. Been in command pretty much right throughout.
First service. Ball.
yes, so close.
That was home.
15-30.
Just had to clear the tape.
Nevertheless, Denton still in plenty of strife. 3-4, 15-30. That's an ace.
30-all.
This is ace number 7.
There's no doubt about that one. Well, Denton guessed right there. He decided to stay where he was and hope that Kriek hit down the line. 50-50 chance, he was right.
1. Game, Denton. 4 games all.
And after a shaky opening to that service game, where once again he didn't get any of the first serves in, opening 3 points, got them in at the right end anyway. 4 all.
Fault.
And a double.
Double fault. Love, 15.
Well, Denton's getting plenty of chances on Kriek's serve.
Kriek served 8 doubles now, and he's catching up to Denton, who is 1 in front on that score.
That Johan Kriek's very low percentage also of first serves in.
Out. 15 all.
Hasn't got him into the trouble really that it should have, because Steve Denton is making too many errors on the returns.
You'd have a great game if you mixed Denton's serve and Kriek's ground strokes, wouldn't you, Al?
Yeah.
Up. 15-30. Not up.
Ooh.
30-all.
Poor boy just happened to get in the right. Well, Steve Denton, certainly a very likable character.
Game, Kriek. Kriek leads 5-4. Time.
That's the view from our Clark Mobile Crane of the Pak Kuyong Centre Court Stadium. Finals day of the Marlborough Australian Open.
Quiet, please.
Steve Denton to serve. Denton down 4-5 in the third and trailing two sets to love from the South African.
Love, 15. Double fault. Love, 30.
A little murmur going through the crowd. They're wondering, is this it? 4-5, love 30.
Denton moving into double figures on the double fault score.
Yep. 15-30.
Still Kriek 2 points from match.
All. Oh, so close. Yep. Oh, Denton can't believe it. Thought he had
40,
the winner.
30.
Well, you would, wouldn't you?
Yes, well, he mistimed that smash, but still you would think it would have been good enough. You watch it here.
Right, please.
Just mistimes that. You see, it doesn't really get away. And Kriek, so close.
Out. Jeez.
That brings up match point.
Advantage, Kriek.
Can Denton hang in?
Let
first service.
Slowing down that first serve. Yes, he saved that match point.
Juice.
And smart thinking there, just getting that first serve in about three-quarter pace, nice and deep, and right on top of the net for the volley.
Unplayable serve.
Advantage, Denton.
You notice then back at Juice in a bit safer position. He could afford to really go for the first serve then.
Whew, some power there.
Oh, what a superb shot.
Juice.
Kriek looking at the heavens and saying, thank you. Slipping. Denton saying, don't make it look so easy. Well,
he has been, hasn't he?
It's a great shot for him, that backhand down the line. Has been all tournament.
4-5 and deuce. Match point again.
Out.
Kriek can't believe his
advantage
luck.
Advantage Kriek. Quiet, please.
Championship point to the South African. Saved another one.
Now, juice.
Well, Kriek electing to run around that. Got himself into a bit of trouble. I think if I was him, I'd have stayed with my backhand. It's worked so well for him.
Double fault.
Third match point now for Kriek.
Advantage, Kriek.
Yes.
Yes.
Ace number 8. Got the tape.
Advantage Kriek. Quiet, please.
Championship point number 4.
Cheers.
Kriek can't put him away.
Advantage, Denton. Quiet, please.
It's about a metre long.
Second service ace for the game. Denton hangs in there.
And listen to that applause for Denton. Saving 4 match points.
And game, Denton, 5 games all. Dean Lowe. 30-15. Out, 30 all.
Well, that's a break point for Steve Denton.
40.
Well served.
Yes. Advantage, Denton.
That's a case of the shoe being on the other foot, isn't it? Second break point in this 11th game of the third set to Steve Denton. Tremendous applause.
Game, Denton. Denton leads 6-5.
Well, what a comeback. It's pretty hard to describe how Denton has got himself back into this set except by sheer persistence. Well, he may not win the championship. That is probably a rash statement to make, but he certainly won a lot of friends by his display. Absolutely incredible. Four match points down in the 10th game and now has a chance to serve out the third set.
Time.
Denton's got the
quiet,
crowd.
Please.
So Steve Denton to serve for the third set.
First service.
6-5. First service from Steve Denton after a let.
Ain't love. Double fault. 15 all.
That brings up the even dozen on that score.
Double fault. 15-30.
Well, just when Steve Denton looks like he could take out this third set, those two doubles, makes it doubtful again.
30 all.
Three.
30-40.
Well, certainly these last couple of games have been rather dramatic. It'd be hard to predict what's actually going to happen.
Extremely difficult.
Break back point. That is the break back, you wouldn't believe it. Tie break now. Kriek.
Six games all, the tie break will now be played.
Plenty of drama.
Quiet, please.
In games 10, 11 and 12 of this set. Kriek to serve the first point from the clubhouse end.
And Steve Denton undoing all that great work that he'd done in saving those match points and then breaking.
One all.
Caught short.
Two, one, Denton.
Ten aces to Steve Denton. Yes, in.
Three, one, Denton. Four, one, Denton.
Why the hell did you miss
that? Quiet, please. Quiet, please. Denton.
Well, I'd hate to predict it, but this time it looks like Steve Denton's third set, doesn't it?
You don't like to say it.
Well,
he's certainly deserved it.
Yes, I think so, and I think about 10,000 people would agree with that.
5-1 in the tiebreak to Denton. One serve to come. That gives him set point. Five set points to Steve Denton.
6-1 Denton.
Can the likable Texan take it out? Wind catching the ball toss of Kriek. It's gusting up to about 20 knots now.
Second service.
Denton takes it to four sets. And he's going to take the break. He certainly won the crowd here at Kooyong, Steve Denton.
Game. In third set, Denton. 7-6. Kriek leads 2-1. There'll be an interval, ladies and gentlemen, 10 minutes.
You got the ball, Steve? The ball, you need the ball.
1 game to go.
Two shot.
Yep. Well, Alan Stone, as we mentioned just a few minutes ago, it's pretty hard to make predictions at this stage of the match. Steve Denton being such an unpredictable player, and I guess it boils down once again to him getting that first serve working, doesn't it?
Yes, and I'm sure that's why he took the break. Even though he won the third set, I'm sure he wanted to go and have words with his coach, Warren Jakes, about, I'd say, his whole game. He hasn't been serving all that well, and also his ground strokes haven't been working. He's had quite a few opportunities on second serves. He's made quite a few errors, so he'd won the third set, but still very quickly off the court, and I'm sure he's talking with Charlie Jakes now about, first of all, how pleased he is to still be in the match, because remembering he saved those 4 match points in the 10th game.
Right.
So he got off the court very quickly, and I'm sure he's chatting with Charlie now about, hey, I'm still in this, perhaps I can win it. What should I do?
Well, we did notice yesterday when we had the rain break, although it was short, he came back out, before which he was serving rather atrociously, and when he did come out after that break, Alan, he was serving a lot better. And he told us in the aftermatch interview, Charlie told him to toss the ball a little bit higher, and we've been noticing that today. He's talking to himself, saying, toss the ball higher.
Well, actually, the reason he wants to toss it higher, it's rather remarkable, his serve. We might get a shot of it when the play resumes, but he actually hits the ball on the way up, a bit like Roscoe Tanner in that regard. And if he doesn't throw it high enough, because he is hitting it on the way up, he's going to make a few errors on the serve. But I was speaking to Warren Jakes this afternoon while he was warming up Steve Denton for this match, and he says if ever there was a rain delay in a tennis tournament that he was thankful for, it was yesterday. And he said that he certainly did have words with Steve yesterday, and he feels that was a contributing factor that helped turn the match around for him yesterday.
You've been very keen in suggesting that he try and chip the ball instead of driving it. Do you think that if he does this in the next set, he could get back into the match?
Well, I think so. I think he's really giving away too many free points. Kriek isn't serving all that well himself.
No.
Very low percentage of first serves. And Steve Denton is continually driving the return of serve and making a lot of errors off it. I think he should vary it. I'm not saying he should just hit all chips. What I'm saying is that he should vary it. He should try and keep the ball in play a little bit more on the returns. All good grass court players chip the returns and then they also drive them. They mix them up, in other words. And Steve Denton isn't doing that. But I think he can put it down to his great fighting spirit, really, that he's in this match still. I thought it was a great performance to come back from 4 match points down in the 10th game. He then got a service break and then, tragically, served 3 double faults to get to the tie break. Now, then to win the tie break is another great performance, because that would shatter most people, you know.
That's
to,
right.
To get back, serve for the set, throw it away with 3 doubles. You wouldn't expect them to regroup quickly enough to come back and win the tie break 7-1.
Alan, in the first set, we saw almost a repetition of what happened yesterday in Kriek's match against Mark Edmondson when he led 5 games to love. Did you see that as a little bit of nervousness on behalf of Denton, or just the good play of Kriek, or a combination of both?
I think a combination of both. Steve Denton looked to be a little nervous. He wasn't moving very freely, and that's usually a sign of nerves. You just don't move well enough. You seem anchored to the spot when you're nervous. But Kriek really did start off well, though. He was hitting his backhand winners, and right throughout the match, actually, he's looked the better player. You know, I guess we could say that really he's very unlucky not to have won the match. He's had four match points. He's looked superior right throughout. It's only Steve Denton's, well, his fighting qualities, his great heart that have kept him in it. And now that he has got back in it, I think Kriek will have to lift the level of his game. I'd say he's still favoured, leading 2-1, but I think he will have to lift the level of his play just the same.
Yes, you specifically pointed out his service. What will we mention what Denton was possibly doing wrong? What's Kriek doing wrong
at
the moment?
It's a little bit breezy here today. It seems to me that he's throwing the ball a little low, but also a little bit too far over his head. And he's getting a few... Well, he's been erratic on serve, and he should be used to the centre court here, or they both should be. The wind is about the same as it's been the last 3 or 4 days, and it's not as if this is the first match for them now. This is the final. They've had a lot of tennis out here on the centre court under similar conditions. So I think we can probably expect them both to play better tennis in the fourth set.
Alan, just while we have the opportunity, we didn't get a chance to talk to you earlier about the statements made by Philippe Chatrier on the rejoining of the men's and women's Australian Open. The Women's Tennis Association, through Jerry Diamond, issued a statement today that they were not in favour of the two tournaments being rejoined in view of the success here in Australia with the women's circuit in the last couple of years. What are your thoughts on it?
Well, I would say that wasn't a surprising statement at all from the Women's Tennis Association. I don't see why they would necessarily bend over backwards to reunite with the men. After all, they were sort of forced to move in the first place. They took the risk. They moved to early or late November, early December. Their tournament is an outstanding success.
It is. Yes.
From their point of view, why would they need to rejoin with the men? I think it would be a good move if we could have the men and women playing together again. Not necessarily, it doesn't have to be at that particular time. There are a few other problems about scheduling lead-up tournaments,
yes,
etc. But I always feel that a Grand Slam tournament should be played under similar conditions as the other three. In other words, 128 draw for the men and women playing, mixed doubles, the whole bit. I think they both should be there, as are in the conditions for Wimbledon, the French Open and the US Open. So there's still a few problems to be ironed out.
Quite a few, I would say. Okay, we'll take this break and be back at Kooyong in just a moment. Sorry, what? Oh, right.
How many more minutes have we got?
I don't know.
We could talk a bit about some of the juniors, if you like, like Windahl's match with Cash, and then I went out and watched some of the 14 and under finals this morning, so if we're struggling for a couple of minutes. So we could always do something like that.
What?
Your camera? Yeah, right.
Okay, here we go. Here we go. Thank you.
The wind gets a bit windy up here, don't we? Get blown there. But it's lucky it's gone to 4 sets. It's going to finish at 3 o'clock.
Yeah, I know.
And the doubles have finished. We'd have an hour to fill. At least it's good for the program.
Say about the juniors. Well, we can Cash just... surprise being beaten.
We can talk about that for a couple of minutes. And we'll see the guy. I only saw the second set, but he really played some great ground strokes. He doesn't have a two-hander like some of the other Swedes. This kid. Linesmen are out.
Linesman back on the court for the resumption of play. The players now, and just take a peek over my shoulder.
Johan Kriek coming back on to centre court. Can't see Steve Denton just as yet, but he can't be too far away. Just while we have a couple of moments, Alan, the result of the juniors, disappointing from Australia's point of view. Pat Cash being beaten in straight sets.
Yes, I guess so. I did watch the second set, and Jorgen Windahl played from Sweden, played exceptionally well, particularly his ground strokes. His backhand in particular was outstanding. But
he hasn't got a two-handed.
No, he doesn't have a two-handed like most of the Swedes. He's a rather conventional player, but certainly there was an outstanding performance from his. But I guess we could be disappointed with Cash, but then when you think about it, he really is only... He's still 16. He's got a couple of years back in the juniors. I think sometimes we forget most of the others playing in the 18 and under are, in fact, 18. Pat Cash is still only 16, so he's had an outstanding year for a 16-year-old, and I would think that either next year or the year after, he will win the Australian Junior.
What about Wally Massur?
I believe that match yesterday that Wally Massur played, in which
14-12 in the
14-12, in which he had match points, was one of the most outstanding matches of the tournament. Three or four people came up and told me that Wally, certainly it was no disgrace, he played outstandingly. And you can tell now by the fact that Windahl went on and defeated Pat Cash in straight sets. So Wally Massur has had a very good tournament. He's been a bit unlucky. I guess he lost in the first round of the Open after having match point, and then to lose the semi-finals of the Junior after having match points. But I think he and Pat Cash could be pretty pleased with their showing this year.
All right, well, players just about to get underway. 2-1 in favour of Johan Kriek against Steve Denton.
Love 15. Love 30.
Fine pickup there from Steve Denton. He was staring Love 40 right in the face.
Denton leads one game to Love. New balls, please.
Johan Kriek to serve. Down love one in the fourth set. Kriek serving with new balls.
Love 15. Wait, please. Light. Game, Kriek. One game all.
So both players holding their opening serve in the fourth set, so a 10-minute break not interfering with their concentration.
Game, Denton. Denton leads 2-1. Fourth set.
All three games played in the fourth set and all going comfortably with the server. Steve Denton, although he served the double fault in that game, looking pretty confident.
Just trying to pick up any changes in the players' game since the break. I think
quiet,
we can
please
say that Steve Denton has eased off the power a bit on the serve.
Fault.
Going for a higher percentage of first serves in.
Fault. 15 love. Love. 40 love. Game, Kriek, 2 games all.
Well, Johan Kriek holding serve, and of course he would have had a talk with his coach, Bobby Brett, during the break. There's Tony Jewell,
Richmond football coach, and his lovely wife, Marg.
Love, 15.
Yes, we haven't got an Australian in the final, but both of these boys coached by Australians. There's got to be a lesson there somewhere.
Love, 15. 40, 15. Double fault. 40, 30.
Hold serve.
Game, Denton. Denton leads 3-2.
5 games played in the fourth set, and Denton having taken a little bit of that power off, looking much more composed out there on centre court. Some of the members of the VIP party now resuming their seats. The federal member for Wills, Mr. Bob Hawke, I can see. Walter Jonah, the state minister for social welfare, a little bit further along in the second row. Philippe Chatrier, of course, was there before. I think must be having a second cup of coffee. And Hamilton Hurley, of course, the managing director of the Marlborough Company.
Quiet, please. Service. Quiet,
first service,
please.
Of Kriek after that let. He trails 2-3 in the fourth, leading 2-1.
Fifteen love. 30 love.
Yes, you've got to hit them dead centre, otherwise they're not hit cleanly, the wind will take them. That was hit dead centre. Didn't deviate at all.
40-15.
Kriek continuing to spend a lot of time at the baseline behind his second serve. He knows he's got the better ground strokes. The only problem for him will be, though, if Denton chips and charges on his second serve. Well, came up with the answer there.
Game, Kriek, three games all.
Pretty tough way to keep having to hold your serve, though. Hit passing shots.
Well, some of Creek's passing shots in the match have been brilliant.
So the first six games going comfortably with the servers in this fourth set.
Love 15.
And again, very noticeable that Denton taking some of the pace off that first serve.
Love 30. Love 40.
And how very quickly the pattern of a match can change.
Yes, just missing that volley on the first point, and then Kriek coming up with two winners. Don't think Denton would have got that even if he hadn't have slipped.
First serve.
The break.
Game, Kriek. Kriek leads 4-3.
And the break achieved by two volleying errors from Denton and two winners from Kriek. And very quickly, Johan Kriek once again getting on top after it seemed we were in for a tight battle in the fourth set.
Be seated, please.
Four, three. First vital break in the fourth, going for Kriek.
Love 15.
And we notice Steve Denton chipping that return, kept him in the point,
and a brilliant lob.
Love 15 all. 30-15.
I would say that Johan Kriek is slowing his serve down a bit, going for a three-quarter pace with a bit of spin on it, particularly early in the game.
Second service. First service. Game, Kriek. He leads 5-3.
Well, the score on the screen, and once again, Johan Kriek in a winning position. Yes, that's a superb shot, using the wind beautifully.
Love, 15.
We'll watch it again here, the top spin. Almost side spin, starting outside the line and curling it in.
Another one.
Love, 30.
Once again, Kriek sneaking up to within 2 points of the championship, remembering that he had 4 match points in the 10th game of the third set.
Missed it.
15-30.
Yes.
Yes, on the line.
Living dangerously, nevertheless. Match point.
30-40.
And this is the fifth.
Saves another one.
Juice.
Wind gusting pretty strongly now.
Advantage, Kriek.
Well, that makes an even half dozen championship points that Kriek has had.
Please.
And that of the 6 match points, that's been by far the easiest that Kriek has had. Fairly short second serve on his forehand.
Advantage, Denton.
And Denton's hung on.
Game, Denton. Kriek leads 5-4.
Well, Johan Kriek now to be serving for the match. Match points he's had before have been on the serve of Steve Denton. And of course, Denton broke back in that 11th game of the third set to take it eventually to the tie break, which he won 7-1. So Denton not out of the woods yet by any stretch of the imagination.
Quiet, please. Love 15.
Well, Steve Denton, is he going to pull another Houdini trick? He's got the first point.
And Kriek aces him for only the fourth time in the match.
All. Those 6 match points that he saved, of course, have been all on his own serve. This is the first time that Kriek has been serving for the match.
He's not done yet. Let's take a look at that again. Whips that across court. Match point number 7.
40-30.
Out. 7 save. It's got to be some sort of a record.
Cheers. Fault.
Match point number 8.
Advantage, Kriek.
And that was a chance, actually, for Denton.
Quiet,
second serve in his forehand with Kriek at the baseline, and he netted the return.
No, that's it. That's the championship. Kriek wins the Marlborough Australian Open for 1981 in 4 sets, defeating a very game and a very popular Steve Denton. Match played in fine spirit. And what a great example this young Texan has set.
That's right.
He didn't win the championship, but he won the stadium, and I dare say hundreds of thousands of fans throughout Australia with his great sportsmanship. More like Steve Denton for mine.
Graham. Game, set, and championship to Kriek, 3-1, 6-2, 7-6, 6-7, 6-4. Thank you, linesman. Thank you, ball boy.
That's the score on screen. A memorable final because it showed great sportsmanship and great fighting. And certainly setting a fine example in sportsmanship to everyone watching. He didn't win the title, as I said, but he certainly won the hearts of many. And I wish there were more like Steve Denton.
Yes, he just didn't get the serve working today. We said at the start that was going to play a key role in this match. He didn't serve as well as he would like to, and neither did that matter for Johan Kriek. But Kriek's all-round game just too superior to Steve Denton, and pretty, even though good fight back in that third set, a pretty comfortable victory to Johan Kriek.
Let's get the presentation underway now. Here is Gary Wilkinson to introduce the president of the LTAA, Brian Tope.